The other problem with the detonating bombs strategy is that would kill me, like, over and over again, because the bombs do quite a lot of damage to me. If I were super high level, it would be good. That said, levels don't make much of a difference compared to equipment in this game, and my equipment is like tier 2, so there's not much room for improvement left.
Surely. Surely that suffices.
Well, it suffices to spawn our great friends, the Reapers. But it looks like there's no... More divides needed, maybe? Or more time? I don't know. We'll give it a bit of both. Train going by, apologies. Need to buff the backup party. Mustn't the gas. You know, given we could also potentially try berserking the Reapers. I mean, their physical attack is brutally powerful, and I think it inflicts stop, but it can't be as bad as them casting death all the time. Well, right, it probably can. No, I've changed the gambits now. They'll only target ice weak foes rather than the party leader's target. I mean, convenient as the party leader's target thing is for general chaining, it's not especially useful here. I'd rather just absolutely guarantee that the only one they'll ever be attacking is lava eater. Really, I should have done it sooner, but I was being lazy. Man, I'm gonna be up late getting this thing. See any extra divide since I came here, despite killing several of these guys. There's a new one. We are just not getting any divides. Guys, come on, just sort of... make with the mitosis already. Is it mitosis or meiosis? Any biologists willing to help me out here? I wish I knew whether that you came from a divide was the spawn. Ways to cure their farm. Thank you. really I should have been doing this the whole time. Easy sky jewels, yeah. They continue to refuse to divide. They do this to make me mad. If there's anything in the Sky Pirates then for cast poison a zillion times. Ah, okay, the Sky Pirates then lags the game out. Premiere Prestidigitator. I like that. Well, that was pointless but fun. Gonna divide? No, not interested. Goddamn necrophobes, you're the reason Japan has such a low birth rate. Thank you. Now there's a saying, to go without solitude is like going without salt. Hadn't encountered that one before, and I gotta say, I like it. As idioms go, that one is getting taken home. Have any of these divided? It seems like it's been forever since one has. Well, be they divided enough or not, I think we've been at this long enough. Let's try running backwards and forwards instead. Reapers, yes. unpleasant. There he is, behind the Reapers. Familiar story. Would that I could just sort of reach over and not have to fight the Reapers. That would be really quite the improvement by itself. Well, I guess we'd better get our equipment back. Maybe light armor would fare better. Just for extra HP. No, they don't really deal damage as much as just remove your HP. This guy needs Indigo Pendant, obviously, to land slow. Langosh, of course. I don't think Mirror Mail would work. It would be an interesting try. We could reflect Doom and Death, I think. We wouldn't be able to reflect... No, we'd just run out of items trying to stay healed. Alright, another exciting... 4-on-1, 4-on-3 boss battle. where we can kill one of them. No, they're doing their weird not aggro thing. I really wish they wouldn't do that. Just, yeah, wander off to the other side. Alright. Good pull, good pull. Good job, Bosch. No, no, Reaper, no. Yeah, you stay on the platform. See, that Reaper is just like, I'm coming. He knows it's completely bullshit for him to come and aggro when we're right next to the exit, but he's gonna do it anyway. Behold, what did I tell you? And another one's shown up as well. You see why this is so annoying? You get a perfect pull-off, and then the Reapers are like, no, 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 we're going to violate all reasonable game mechanics and wander up to you. Got very lucky there, hitting the Kiraga just before Bubble went off, effectively doubling the healing. Barsh is now getting basically beaten too often to cast slow. I don't really have any massive single target damages, do I? Especially not getting parries every goddamn attack. boy, this is miserable. Fine, we'll go and rebuff off screen, because that's so fair. I love having to do that game. It's like, I just walked across an arbitrary line, now you can't get me. Nothing. Well, of course. Of course nothing. What else would it be? You guys missed the zoning as much as I did. Literally got a string tied around the controller while I read my book. Thank you. nothing. Was I impatient, or has it deglitched, I wonder? Well, patience is easily replicated, at least. Looks like it's no simple impatience. He's gone. Back to poisoning necrophobes. Yay! Hope you're all as happy about that as I am. Thank you. the next two kills, say, well, that could be easily another hour or two. But your confidence is absolutely charming, and I appreciate it. This guy's not interested in dividing. Let's see if we can find another one. Where do you come from? Were you just a spawn, or did you divide? This is why it gets annoying. Like, is the divide count zero? I guess he's A, so he must be a spawn? Or... Ah, right, that's one divide. Good, good. And that gives us D and A. That's two divides over there. And that gives us A, C, and D. Heh. That's it on E. Where did E come from? Oh, for fuck's sake. Let's just put it at two divides that I've noticed. Doing it manually. Alright, see you in 5 hours, when we're fine. At this point, I wouldn't disbelieve it. I'm here till I get back. It's perfectly possible to leave this running overnight. Admittedly, I probably shouldn't leave it streaming overnight, just running between the two screens, and that'll just keep ticking up the count as long as I know that it is counting. And when the count gets to 512 and 1024 and so on, you get an extra larva each spawn without having to run through the screens again. You don't have to zone two screens away, but you don't have to zigzag. I probably wouldn't stream that, though. I'm hopeful that no one would watch a string holding down a controller, running backwards and forwards for 10 hours. course, forcing the drop if I'm not streaming is actually trivial, so... Still really boring, but slightly less onerous. There's divide number 4, I believe. Or was it 3? Divide number 4/5. Look for hope one more divide and we'll be done. Okay, we got 2 more spawns. That's irritating since they won't divide until the other 2 are dead. Come on, one more divide. Make me a differently miserable person. Well, it seems like there are more than there were before, but I'm not sure if that's because they divided or spawned, because I was pouring myself a glass of wine. As one does. See, these two new ones just spawned, they didn't divide. Which is irritating, because they're now blocking divisions, which we need. Are you going to divide? Yes. Good enough. The best part is, we're guaranteed to have some Reapers when we get one. Thank you. Well, there's a spot of luck and or success or whatever you call it at this point. I see a lava eater and no reapers. Well, there are the reapers, but life is cruel. I don't think we're gonna get as good a pull this time. That's one reaper aggro, sure. Ah, that's a lot of red lines. Well, never mind. Buff up and we'll fight all three Reapers and Lava Eater. Sure, why not? Can you just leave, Mr. Ghost? We're busy. Oh yeah. Really, we didn't think this through at all. We do need one Mad Gush, don't we? We didn't need to take the Cleric's robes. I'm not sure which part I hate more, the inexplicable not spawning so we have to kill more ghosts, or the foul luck with getting Reapers aggro pretty much every time, and it's just a nightmare. Because they don't listen to rhyme or reason, and they just want to kill you. Still, well, maybe we'll get lucky and land a whole ton of attack. Slows even. Or maybe we'll just beat him to death while Barsh keeps them busy. That would be nice. You know, this parry is really annoying. Let's switch to a gun. The damage will be a bit worse, of course, but... It's okay, I get that ammunition is a confusing concept, but... At least let us force attacks through. Is that nothing again? It actually was. It was actual nothing. Well, my thinking is reflect would block doom and death, but not annul and invert, which realistically are much more of a problem. That said, well, the other problem is that it's really... Actually, no, maybe I could go for, like, reflect reverse? I don't know about that, that seems... Like, I really don't want to get reverse onto them. Or onto Lava Eater, at least. Well, yeah. Because, like, in order to get reverse on them, it means I can't be using Mirror Mail for Reflect, because I have to cast Reverse and then I have to cast Reflect. Oh, sorry, cast Reflect. No, yeah, that way around. First way around. Trouble is, it's not at all a bad idea. Because getting out from under death and would be, you know, really nice. Yeah, you can reverse and reflect. But, Reverse wears off much faster than reflect does, though. So you can't have Gambit set for it, because reverse will wear off and then they'll try to reverse themselves and reflect the reverse. Maybe I could have just Barsh under... No, it still doesn't seem... If I had Opal Ring to pierce Reflect, I think I'd do it. But for some reason I don't. I think they were available for sale somewhere and I just didn't buy any. Just check. Yeah, I didn't buy you up a ring. No piercing magic for me. Yeah, Guildhosser is, well, Guildhosser is effective, but I think I'm a bit poor. Don't know what my cash looks like at the moment, but it's certainly no more than 100k. I do these things because otherwise it wouldn't be challenging. Obviously, the aim is to make it not challenging. That's the challenge. Why did it have to be Reapers? Why couldn't it have been, like, bombs? Bombs would be fine. We could totally handle it if that room were full of bombs. I mean, sure, it would hurt when they exploded, but then they'd be gone. I'll admit, I wasn't expecting this to take quite this long. 8 hours rather than 10 or so, but... That's life with Lava Rita. He just sits there, smug as heck, knowing that the only fair way or only reasonable way to spawn him is glitching the game, and... has absolutely no obligation to drop anything at all. You know, that can common drop Demon Eyeball, which at level 4 change would be like 90% drop rate, but we've missed drops entirely for 10 runs in a row or something stupid.
So I can't help but feel that something's going wrong with the drop mechanics.
Which, you know, is reasonable, given that we are deliberately glitching the game. Oh, well, there he is, at least. Ugh. I hate Reapers so much. And the thing is, the longer you wait around here for them to, like, wander away, the more they'll just be, like, inexplicably wandering closer. Not sure what will happen if I run two zones of- oh, for pity's sake. Alright, I guess we're gonna find out what happens if I run two zones away. Yeah, no, see, if you wait for the Lava Eater to come over, all that happens is the Reapers come over. The Lava Eater just follows a, you know, like a normal wandering path. The Reapers, on the other hand, just, they know you're there. If I zone two screens away, I don't know if it'll reset Lava Eater or not. It shouldn't do, really. But it might. You know what? I just don't want to deal with Reapers right now. I'm giving it a go. Because sometimes the area appears with no Reapers at all. Which is also, of course, completely inexplicable, but... at least it's a good kind of inexplicable. The longest ranged... I don't actually know what the ranges are, but... it might be arrow, I'm not sure. Well, it looks like we've despawned a lot of them. Which continues to defy explanation, but, that's irritating. Well, back to repeatedly zoning and hoping we haven't broken it.
I think most of the spells are the same, and are slightly longer than all the weapons, which I'm pretty sure are the same. Of course, this was also spawned Reapers sometimes, which I still don't get, because only once shouldn't change the monsters that are available. Unless the problem is really that the Reapers should be actually truly invisible rather than merely outlines. And zoning bugs out their invisibility so they become partly visible. I don't know. There, see, the Reaper is back. Or Reapers. Though Lava Eater isn't. I guess I just didn't wait long enough, but... it seems weird, since the kill counter should still be huge.
I don't know.
Well, the good news is, one way or another, it'll be over soon. Guys will almost petrify. Otherwise, believe me, I'd be abusing the heck out of it. Best spell in the game right there. See, this guy, he's not aggroed, he's not got any red lines indicating that he's going to come and attack me, but he's just going to keep moving in my direction on average.
I really hope I haven't broken the glitch again and have to kill necrophobes for a while.
Or it would be nice if warp didn't break your chain. Like, I don't know why it does, but apparently, you know, getting no loot, no experience, and no license points isn't punishment enough for using a spell to get rid of enemies. Oh well. Try zoning twice again, I guess, but I'm pretty sure what the game wants me to do is kill more necrophobes. At this point, I must be close to just getting 256 actual kills of the things. Although I suppose the ones that, before I screwed up and had to leave, don't count. Why not get Holy, because it's not available until after the forest at Ridorana. Renew would be really good as well, but also not available until after the forest, since it reduces targets to one hit point, if they're undead. Although it only has a chance of working. Thank you.
course, Ryu is also really expensive, like, in mana. And I probably also in guild, but, irrelevant. Oh, yeah, maybe I could draw it to the edge and then kill it and get out. That's not a bad idea. Yeah, that's a good idea. I'm not sure if it works for non-teleporting enemies, but it's a really good idea. Actually, no, of course it does. It works for Limberwolf, doesn't it? He doesn't teleport. You can do that if you're going full no-life mode to get a lot of prime pelts early in the game. And then you can use those to make Brave Suit, I think? Which I still haven't made, which maybe I should actually. Crown of Laurels might be good here.
Yeah, exactly.
I'll give that a go, I think. Thanks. What's with the zero poison damage?
Dividing, that's one divide. Is he doing it twice? I'm sorry. And then his divide teleported in. We could evolve resistance to poison. Yeah, that would be really interesting. Really difficult to fit into the already quite large game, but it would be very, very good. I'm not really sure it would be fair to include it in such a farming-based game, though. Because, like, figuring out a strategy is kind of the aim of the game, and then if the game just says, no, no, that's not working anymore, be irritating. There are things like the white chocobo that change their elemental resistance. It's kind of similar.
It doesn't really help that the inside of the Great Crystal is one of the visually most boring and unpleasant environments in the game. Like, it's a cave made of, like, sort of orangish rock that glows sometimes. And it's crystal. We Atlantis now. I haven't had any problems doing this in Southwood. Or even Navi-Dees. Navi-Dees isn't too bad. Water damage. It's marginally more accessible than earth damage. Actually, not right now. Right now we have earth arrows and earth shot, but only water shot. No water arrows. I don't think there are any. No, wait, we have water bombs as well, though our bomb launcher is terrible. Which, I mean, our bomb launcher is what you would reasonably expect to have at this point in the story if you were really keen on using bomb launchers. Because the best ones aren't available until after Pharos again. Ah, oh, that's another divide over there. Okay. It's two or three, I hope. Oh, good. I was starting to worry I'd run out of these guys. We want there to be three spawned ones all at once, because that means we can't get any divides out of them. Getting these guys to divide continues to be nightmarishly difficult. All we need to do is divide all three times, and I think we're done.